So we have people call us all the time and say, my house is cold. I'm cold all winter long. What's going on? I have this high efficiency furnace and my house is cold. Well, it's probably not your furnace. Your furnace, if you've had it checked regularly, your furnace is probably working fine. But there are some things that you should look for why a house may be cold. One of them is the obvious things of infiltration around your windows and your doors and checking your weather stripping and that kind of thing. But did you know that most people's houses are cold because they're in a negative pressure? And so because the house is negative air pressure inside versus the outside, you open the door to come in, a rush of cold air comes in. That cold air is cold and cold air can't hold near as much moisture, so it's low humidity. And because it's low humidity and it's colder air coming in, you're gonna feel cold. The other thing is when your house is in a negative pressure and you have infiltration, it can be bringing cold air in around your windows and your doors. So people say, well, why would my house be in a negative pressure? Well, think about it. You run your dryer runs air and exhausts it outside. You take a shower, you turn on your exhaust fans, and it's exhausting indoor air outside. That's air that you paid to heat or cool in the summertime that's being exhausted outside. That air has to come in from somewhere. So your house is naturally going to be in a negative pressure. The key to those things is that if you're going to run your dryer, do it at night when everybody's sleeping, so you don't notice that cold air coming in around your windows and your doors. Something else that you may consider is putting timers on your bathroom exhaust fans, so they can only run for 15 or 20 minutes and then shut off. A lot of cases we see people coming in that are complaining about that, and you go to their house to examine it and the bathroom exhaust fans are all on. So putting a timer on the bathroom exhaust fan makes a big difference in somebody's house. But the biggest thing is understanding that not only do those things cause your house to be in a negative pressure, you have other things that are exhausting air out of your house as well. One of them is your water heater. When your water heater runs, it sucks air out of your house and runs it up the chimney. Your furnace, if it's not a sealed combustion furnace like this one with two plastic pipes, it's using indoor air for combustion and sending that inside air up through your roof, through your furnace vents. So there are things that you can do there by upgrading your furnace and upgrading your water heater so that they're not continually drawing air out of your house. If you have an older style furnace that has a metal vent coming up, it's sucking air out of your house 24/7, year round. And that is one of the biggest energy inefficiency things that you can do and put your house into a negative pressure. So today's sealed combustion furnaces will help a lot with that indoor air filtration or air infiltration coming into your home. And so, timers on your bathroom exhaust fan. Running your dryer at night when no one's around, or during the day when no one's around, sealing up around those windows and doors, and putting in high efficiency equipment will go a long way to making your house feel a lot warmer.